What's up guys, today we got something special. I got a package from Poland. And in this package I ordered some mantids. I ordered them from Exo Factory, which is a site where you can buy them. And I'm very nervous to open this. I've seen a lot of comments about this site that it ships dead animals and a lot of negatives, but also some positives. So there is a chance that these animals are alive and there's a chance that they are dead. I ordered quite a lot of species, which I will show you guys right now. So yeah, let's open it and see what's inside.
I have no idea if these will be alive. He ordered for about... well, I don't know what the price was, but it was in zlotys, and it was about 70 euros. And that was this is basically my birthday gift from him. And we're gonna see if this is okay. I actually bought 3 heat packs so that they will arrive alive. Oh, well, I can already see one that's alive. I can see 2 that's alive. Oh, here are the heat packs. I can see a lot of movement, which is very good. There's also fruit flies in there. This is just some ventilation, I think. And here are the heat packs. Oh, this is still warm, so that's good. All right, I got 3 packages. These are all small mantises. I'm gonna bring the camera down a little bit so you guys can see a bit better. And you can already see that these are all alive, I think. That would be really nice. Oh, here are my... it's so stupid because I forgot all the names. I don't know the names, this is just bad preparation, but I knew that the package... I didn't know the package was coming today, so I couldn't really prepare for this. But... I will just put it in the video what the name of the species is. They actually added a lot of fruit flies to make sure that they stay alive. And here you guys can see the babies. You can see one right here. And there is one right there. And these are both alive, so that's really, really good. There's a lot of fruit flies and they're actually flying in my room right now. Here's another species, also both alive. So every animal came alive, which I'm really happy about. They are kind of attacking each other right now. They are underneath here. I don't know if you can see them. There's one crawling over there. And there's one over here. He's coming up right now. And this should be all species that get pretty big and they are pretty aggressive too. And I actually see something very cool. They gave me an extra one. This is a very special species. This is the devil, what was the name again? Basically, this is the devil of all mantises. And I ordered 4 and they actually gave me 5. So that's pretty nice. They gave one for free. So I'm very happy about that. And they are all looking pretty good. So that's good to know. There are not much fruit flies in here anymore. I don't think they will eat a full, a normal fly. Because I think that's a bit too much for them. But they actually eat all of them. I'm pretty sure. So yeah, they all made it. And I'm very happy about that. That's very good. What I want to do now is get a nice enclosure for them. Kind of put them in a enclosure that they deserve. And yeah, let's do that. Alright guys, I made 2 pretty simple cages. As you can see, these are just containers. I added some of this filter in there so that the ventilation will be good. And also did that with this one. I got 2 cages and I have 3 cages here. What's weird actually is that I ordered 4 different species and I only have 3 buckets. So I'm pretty sure that they kind of didn't put one species in. So that's kind of sad. But yeah, it is what it is. But yeah, I'm gonna put them in and then I'll show it to you guys. Alright guys, so the species that I bought, I will pronounce it. I should have in total, let me see, 2, 4, 8, 10. I should have 10 mantids. Here's 2 in this enclosure, 2, so that's 4. And I have 5 in this, so that's 9. but they didn't give me all the species. The species that I bought was Hirudula Blue, and I think that is the green ones, but they will turn, I think, a little blue. I got those two, I think. Pretty sure. Idolomantis diabolica, and those are the four devil mantids. Those are in here, which I'll show you in the next clip. Paraspendale species giant. Sorry if I pronounce it in the wrong. Paraspendale species giant. I don't know if those are this one. Not sure if that is this species. But yeah, it's also pretty hard to see because I ordered two species that look like each other. And these kind of look the same. So it's a bit hard to know that. And Pseudempusa pinapavonis. So Pseudempusa pinapavonis. And they are all L1, L2 nymphs. Right now I have them together. But I'm still not sure if that's okay to still do. What I did is I kept these in here because there are still a lot of fruit flies in here, so these can stay in here for quite a while. So that's not a problem. Until the fruit flies are dead, I will make an enclosure for these. And I added the other two species in here, which I will show you guys right now. Okay, so first of all, I'll show you these. And as you can see, there's two mantids in here. I don't know what species these are. Because they are still L1, L2 mantids, but yeah, these look fine, and I'm gonna keep them in this enclosure for now. I can kind of see that they are sometimes attacking each other. Don't know if that's a problem, but I'll keep an eye on that. They have food enough, so that shouldn't be a problem yet. And most of the mantids can stay together in L1, L2 stage, some even further. Some species can even get communal, like my ghost mantids. But I'll keep an eye on these, see if they stay okay. Okay, I'm gonna try to record it like this, because I can't really record it in a different way, because this species is very quick, and when I try to put them in this enclosure, they actually escape pretty fast, so... And you know, it's kind of hard to put such a small insect in an enclosure that fast when it's escaping, because if you just hold it, you already crush it to death. But you can see that they are sitting on top here, and this should be the blue species that I just pronounced. All right, here are the devils, and you can see that these are actually pretty relaxed right now. They're not really that stressed out, I think. But what's the weird part about this is that this is actually one of the hardest species to keep, and in my opinion they look the best. They also ate all their fruit flies, and yeah, I'm pretty happy that these are in here. These actually need a lot of temperature, or a pretty high temperature, about 30 to 40 degrees in Celsius. So I'm not sure yet how I'm gonna have to do that, but I'm pretty sure that these babies can have quite some lower temperatures, maybe, because they survived the shipment and they ate a lot, so that's a good sign. Okay, I actually managed to get some footage of the devil mantis, because they're pretty relaxed, and I'm really like that. Some nice footage. I actually tried to feed them a fly, and the fly fell inside, which you can see, and they actually tried to attack it, but it was just too big. You actually saw that guy attacked him. But yeah, very beautiful species already as a nymph. Really nice. Alright guys, I actually found a heat lamp, and I placed it like this. And right underneath there are the devil mantises, and the others are also close to that. So they will have a lot of temperature. There's also a time clock, which actually turns it on in the morning, turns it off in the evening. So I'm pretty sure that this will keep the temperature high for now. Of course, I'm gonna make a new video about the species, because yeah, they will need a much better enclosure once they grow up. And yeah, another nice adventure to see. If you guys like this video, please put a thumbs up. If you want to see more of these videos, plus please subscribe, and I'll see you guys in the next video.